So today we're going to discuss about solving linear equations. When you solve linear equations, you have to follow the following steps. Step number one, make sure to understand that you need to isolate your variable on one side of your equation. Step two, operate on your numbers by following the correct order of operations, which is PEMDAS. Number three, always put the equal sign first to be able to identify your left side and your right side of the equation. Let us do example number one. 2m plus 12 equals 3m minus 31. These m's right here have to stay on one side. Whichever side you prefer does not matter. We will all get the same answer. However, as a strategy, I'm looking at this as a big value for m, and this is the smaller value. You know that when I move this to the other side, the sign will change to the opposite sign, and in this case, it's going to be minus. Therefore, I'm going to choose to put my 2m on the other side, making it look like this. And now, this negative 31 has to join the positive 12, which will now turn to 12 plus 31. And it won't matter. You can write 31 plus 12. It's the same thing. So now let us combine like terms. This is going to be 43 equals 1m, or m is equal to 43, which is the same as, which is actually the same as m equals 43. Okay, now let's have example number two. Example number two is negative 9 plus 8k is equal to 7 plus 4k. So once again, let's apply our strategy. I see these two k's have to be together and the constants have to be together. But this has a bigger k, and so therefore, I'm kind of thinking it's better for me to put this on the other side. Once again, wherever side you choose to combine your like terms does not matter. We will arrive to the same answer. So equal sign first to be able to identify your left and your right. So I will have a positive 8k minus 4k will now equal to 7 plus 9. The sign of 7 stays the same as positive because we did not move it to the other side. And the negative now 9 now turns to a positive 9, making this equal to 4k and this to 16, and that you will have to divide by 4, and now your k is a 4. Example number 3, negative 7 parentheses 2b minus 4, close parentheses equals 5 parentheses negative 2b plus 6, close parentheses. Whenever it is outside the parentheses, you know you need to distribute. And so this would look like negative 14b. Negative 7 times negative 4 is positive 28. And once again, equal sign first. Sorry, I missed that. And this is to be distributed as well, making it negative 10b. Positive 5 times positive 6 is positive 30. Again, the equal sign, whichever side, it won't matter. So I'm just going to move this to the other side. So negative 10b plus 14b. I made it into a positive 14b because it's here, it's negative. And then this is going to turn to positive 28 minus 30. And this now becomes negative 10 plus 14 is a positive 4b. You will subtract them and you will carry the sign of the larger number. And this is going to be a negative 2. And then you divide by 4. Your b is, okay, well, first of all, let's discuss the sign. Positive or negative over positive or positive over negative will give you a negative value, and that is going to be 1/2. So your b is negative 1/2. At this point, you may need to flip over to the next page of your notebook, and so we are going to now have this rational numbers, these fractions. Okay, so 1/2 minus 5 8x equals 7 8x plus 7 over 2. Well, the first thing you will have to do is to get rid of the denominators. What we do not like is to operate with the denominators. And so the way to do that is to get their LCD. And the least common denominator for this one is 8. So the LCD is 8. And that's what I'm going to use to multiply both sides by. I'll multiply that by 8. I will multiply this by 8. And you know that when you multiply those by 8, it will distribute. Okay? When it distributes, it would now look like this. 8 over 1 times 1 half. And you will have minus 5 over 8x. Another times 8 over 1. Okay? I hope you are understanding where these are all coming from. 7, 8x times, again, 8 over 1 plus 7 over 2 times 8 over 1. Okay, so I want you to watch this because these are all, like, that's one of them. This is another one. This is another one. This is another one. We will have to operate all of them. This now will turn into, well, it's 8 times 1 is 8, 1 times 2 is 2, and 8 over 2 is 4. Or you can do this and you can say that it is 4 here and 1 there. Therefore, your answer here is going to be a 4. The 4 is just for this one. That's your 4. Minus, this will be gone. Okay, because that will turn into a 1. Therefore, you're just left with 5x equals. This will be gone because it will turn into a 1. And 7 over 1 is the same as 7x over 1. And you now have, so put the plus sign. And now this is, well, you can do it in two ways. You can say 7 times 8 is 56. And then 2 times 1 is 2. You divide it by 2. Or you can just simply say 8 and 2 can be simplified into 4 and 1. And so now you have 28 over 1 or 28. And then now you can put your like terms together. So this is 7x plus 5x. And this is 4 minus 28. I hope you're understanding that the 5x here became positive because this is negative and I moved it to the other side. The 7x stayed the same because it did not move. The 4x stayed the same. It did not move. And the positive 28 turned into a negative 28 because it went to the other side. Now, therefore, you're going to operate on this one. And by the rule of integers, this is going to turn to negative 24. And this will turn into a positive 12x. Divide that by 12. By this by 12, x is a negative 2. Why negative? Because negative over positive or positive over negative is negative, and 24 divided by 12 is 2. Our fifth and final example is negative x over 7 equals 5. Well, first of all, I already mentioned that whenever we're solving, we want to get rid of the denominator. So that's the very first thing I need to get rid of. And I see that the denominator here is 7. And the way to get rid of this, since this is divide, we always get rid of our number by using its inverse. So the inverse of division is multiply. So I times this by 7, the whole of this. And whatever I do on the left, I have to do on the right. So now this will turn into a 1 because that's considered a 7 over 7 because this is on top having a 1 at the bottom. And this is now just going to be negative x equals 35. Now look how easy this is going to be. Since that's a negative, I don't like a negative. There are two ways of doing this. One is by dividing it by negative 1. If you like it, I'm going to show you both. How about that? So I'm going to divide this by negative 1, both sides. And my x is now going to be, again, positive over negative is negative. 35 over 1 is 35. That's one way. Actually, that's the harder way. The easier way is, what if you have a negative x equals 35 What if I just do this? Since that's a negative, I'll flip it here. It's now is positive, and I need to flip this to the other side as well, making it negative 35. And it's the same.